Catherine Elizabeth Hudson, born October 25, 1984, known professionally as Katy Perry, is an American singer, songwriter, and television judge. Her music has been credited with influencing the pop sound and style of the 2010s decade. Perry sang in church during her childhood before pursuing a career in gospel music as a teenager. She signed with Red Hill Records and released her debut studio album Katy Hudson, 2001, under her birth name, which was commercially unsuccessful. After Red Hill ceased operations, she moved to Los Angeles the following year to venture into secular music, adopting the stage name Katy Perry from her mother's maiden name. Perry subsequently began working with producers Glenn Ballard and Greg Wells on two albums that were later shelved, with much of the material being later reworked onto One of the Boys. 1. Prior to signing a recording contract with Capitol Records in April 2007, she was also dropped by the Island Def Jam Music Group and Columbia Records. Perry rose to fame in 2008 with her second album, One of the Boys, a pop rock record containing her debut single I Kissed a Girl and follow-up single Hot and Cold, which respectively reached number 1 and 3 on the US Billboard Hot 100. The disco-influenced pop album Teenage Dream, 2010, spawned 5 US number 1 singles: California Girls, Teenage Dream, Firework, ET, and Last Friday Night, TGIF. Becoming the first album by a solo female artist to do so, and tied her with Michael Jackson's Bad. A reissue titled Teenage Dream, The Complete Confection, 2012, subsequently had the number one single Part of Me and number two single Wide Awake. Her fourth album Prism, 2013, incorporates pop and dance with themes of self-reflection, everyday life, and relationships. With the music videos for its chart-topping singles Roar and Dark Horse, Perry became the first artist to have multiple videos reach 1 billion views on YouTube. Witness, 2017, featured an electropop sound with a political subtext, themes of liberation, and self-described purposeful pop. Her sixth studio album, Smile, 2020, featured themes of motherhood and self-help. All of Perry's albums released under Capitol have each surpassed 1 billion streams on Spotify. 2. Perry is one of the world's best-selling music artists, having sold over 143 million records worldwide. She has 9 Billboard Hot 100 number 1 singles, 3 Billboard 200 number 1 albums, and has received various accolades, including 4 Guinness World Records, 5 Billboard Music Awards, 5 American Music Awards, a Brit Award, and a Juno Award. Perry has been included in the annual Forbes lists of highest-earning women in music from 2011 to 2019. Her Super Bowl halftime show performance is the most watched in history. Outside of music, she released an autobiographical documentary titled Katy Perry, Part of Me in 2012. And voiced Smurfette in the 2011 comedy film The Smurfs and its 2013 sequel The Smurfs 2. Perry began serving as a judge on American Idol, starting from its 16th season in 2018. Contents: 1. Life and career. 1.1 1984 to 1998, early life and family. 1.2 1999 to 2006, career beginnings, Katy Hudson and Fingerprints. 1.3 2007 to 2009, breakthrough with One of the Boys. 1.4 2010 to 2012, Teenage Dream and First Marriage. 1.5 2013 to 2015, Prism and Super Bowl Zlick's Halftime Show. 1.6 2016 to 2018, Witness and American Idol. 1.7 2019 present, Smile, Motherhood and Play Residency. 2 Artistry. 2.1 Influences. 2.2 Musical Style and Themes. 2.3 Voice. 3 Public Image. 3.1 Fashion. 4 Legacy and Influence. 5 Other Ventures. 5.1 Philanthropy. 5.2 Activism. 6 achievements. 7 discography. 8 filmography. 9 tours and residency. 10 see also. 11 references. 11.1 footnotes. 11.2 sources. 12 external links. Life and career. 1984 to 1998, early life and family. Catherine Elizabeth Hudson was born on October 25, 1984, in Santa Barbara, California, to Pentecostal pastors Mary Christine, née Perry, and Morris Keith Hudson. 3-4, both of her parents turned to religion after a wild youth. 5, Perry has English, German, Irish, and Portuguese ancestry. 6, through her mother, she is a niece of film director Frank Perry. 7, she has a younger brother named David, who is a singer. 8, and an older sister, Angela. 9. From ages 3 to 11, Perry often moved across the country as her parents set up churches before settling again in Santa Barbara. Growing up, she attended religious schools and camps, including Paradise Valley Christian School in Arizona and Santa Barbara Christian School in California during her elementary years. 4-10, her family struggled financially. 11, sometimes using food stamps and eating food from the food bank, which also fed the congregation at Perry's parents' church. 12. Growing up, Perry and her siblings were not allowed to eat the cereal Lucky Charms, as the word luck reminded their mother of Lucifer, and had to call deviled eggs angeled eggs. 13. Perry primarily listened to gospel music. 14. As secular music was generally discouraged in the family's home, she discovered popular music through CDs she sneaked from her friends. 15. Perry later recalled a story about how a friend of hers played You Oughta Know by Alanis Morissette, which impacted her songwriting and singing. 16. While not strictly identifying as religious, she has stated, "I pray all the time, for self-control, for humility." 17. Wanting to be like her sister Angela, Perry began singing by practicing with her sister's cassette tapes. She performed the tracks in front of their parents, who let her take vocal lessons as Angela was at the time. She began training at age 9, 18, and was incorporated into her parents' ministry. 5, singing in church from ages 9 to 17. 19, at 13, Perry was given her first guitar for her birthday, 5-20. And publicly performed songs she wrote. 11, she tried to be a bit like the typical Californian girl while growing up, and started roller skating, skateboarding, and surfing as a teenager. Her brother David described her as a tomboy during her adolescence, which Perry talks about on her song One of the Boys. 21, she took dancing lessons and learned how to swing, Lindy Hop, and jitterbug. 22. 1999 to 2006, career beginnings, Katie Hudson and Fingerprints. Perry completed her general educational development, GED, requirements at age 15, 23, during her first year of high school, 24, and left Dos Pueblos High School to pursue a music career. 25, she briefly had music lessons in facilities rented from the Music Academy of the West. 26, her singing caught the attention of rock artists Steve Thomas and Jennifer Knapp from Nashville, Tennessee, who brought her there to improve her writing skills. 25, in Nashville, she started recording demos and learned how to write songs and play guitar. 14, Perry signed with Red Hill Records and recorded her debut album, a contemporary Christian record titled Katie Hudson, which was released on March 6, 2001. She also went on tour that year as part of Phil Joel's Strangely Normal Tour 27-28, and embarked on other performances of her own in the United States. 29, Katie Hudson received mixed reviews from critics and was commercially unsuccessful, selling an estimated 200 copies before the label ceased operations in December. 30-31, transitioning from gospel music to secular music, Perry started working with producer Glenn Ballard, 32, and moved to Los Angeles at age 17. 33, she opted to work with Ballard due to his past work with Alanis Morissette, one of her major inspirations. In 2003, she briefly performed as Katherine Perry to avoid confusion with actress Kate Hudson. She later adopted the stage name Katy Perry, using her mother's maiden name. 34. In 2010, she recalled that Thinking of You was one of the first songs she wrote after moving to Los Angeles. 35. In 2004, she signed to Ballard's label, Java Records, which was then affiliated with the Island Def Jam music group. Perry began work on a solo record due for release in March 2005, but the record was shelved after Java was dropped. 36. Ballard then introduced her to Tim Devine, an A&R executive at Columbia Records, and she was signed as a solo artist. By November 2006, Perry had finished writing and recording material for her Columbia debut titled Fingerprints, with some of the material from this time appearing on One of the Boys, which was planned for release in 2007. 37. Some of the material from Fingerprints that did not make it on One of the Boys was given to other artists, such as I Do Not Hook Up and Long Shot to Kelly Clarkson and Rock God to Selena Gomez and The Scene. 38. Perry worked with songwriters including Desmond Child, Greg Wells, Butch Walker, Scott Cutler, Ann Previn, The Matrix, Cara Diogardi, Max Martin, and Dr. Luke. 39-40. In addition, after Devine suggested that songwriting team The Matrix become a real group, she recorded a shelved album called The Matrix with them. 41. The Matrix was planned to be released in 2004 but was cancelled due to creative differences. It was later released in 2009 after the release of One of the Boys. Perry was dropped from Columbia in 2006 as Fingerprints neared completion. After the label dropped her, she worked at an independent A&R company called Taxi Music. 42. Perry had minor success prior to her breakthrough. One of the songs she had recorded for her album with Ballard, Simple, was featured on the soundtrack to the 2005 film The Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants. 43. She provided backing vocals on Mick Jagger's song Old Habits Die Hard, 44, which was included on the soundtrack to the 2004 film Alfie. 45. In September 2004, Blender named Perry the next big thing. 43. She recorded background vocals on POD's single Goodbye for Now and was featured at the end of its music video in 2006. That year, Perry also appeared in the music video for Learn to Fly by Carbon Leaf, and played the love interest of her then-boyfriend, Gym Class Heroes lead singer Travie McCoy, in the band's music video for Cupid's Chokehold. 46. 2007-2009, Breakthrough with One of the Boys. After Columbia dropped Perry, Angelica Cobb-Beiler, then a publicity executive at the label, brought Perry's demos to Virgin Records chairman Jason Flom. Flom was convinced that she could be a breakthrough star and she was signed to Capitol Records in April 2007. The label arranged for her to work with Dr. Luke to add an undeniable smash to her existing material. 47-48, Perry and Dr. Luke co-wrote the songs I Kissed a Girl and Hot and Cold for her second album One of the Boys. A campaign was started with the November 2007 release of the video to Er So Gay, a song aimed at introducing her to the music market. 49. A digital EP of the same name was also released that month. 50. Madonna helped publicize the song by praising it on the John Jay and Rich radio show in April 2008. 51. Stating Er So Gay was her favorite song at the time. 52. In March 2008. Perry made a cameo appearance as a club singer in the Wildfire episode Life's Too Short, 53, and appeared as herself during a photo shoot that June on The Young and the Restless for the show's magazine Restless Style. 54. Katy Perry performing on the Warped Tour 2008. Perry was part of the 2008 Warped Tour lineup. Perry released her first single with Capitol, I Kissed a Girl, on April 28, 2008, 55, as the lead single from One of the Boys. The first station to pick up the song was WRVW in Nashville, who were inundated with enthusiastic calls the first 3 days they played it. 56, the track reached number one on the US Billboard Hot 100. 57, I Kissed a Girl created controversy among both religious and LGBT groups. The former criticized its homosexual theme, while the latter accused her of using bi curiosity to sell records. In response to speculation that her parents opposed her music and career, Perry told MTV that they had no problems with her success. 58, One of the Boys, released on June 17, 2008, garnered mixed critical reviews and reached number 9 on the US Billboard 200. 59-60, the album went on to sell 7 million copies worldwide. 61, Hot and Cold was released the following September 62, and became the album's second successful single, reaching number 3 on the Billboard Hot 163, while topping charts in Germany, 64, Canada, 65, the Netherlands 66, and Austria. 67, later singles Thinking of You and Waking Up in Vegas were released in 2009, 68, 69. And reached the top 30 of the Hot 100. 63, The Matrix's self-titled debut album, which Perry had recorded with the band in 2004, was released onto iTunes on January 27, 2009, as a result of her solo success. 45-70. After finishing the 2008 Warped Tour, 71, Perry hosted the 2008 MTV Europe Music Awards in November 2008, where she won the award for Best New Act. 72, at the 2009 Brit Awards, she also won the award for International Female Solo Artist. 73, Perry embarked on her first headlining world tour, the Hello Katie Tour, from January to November 2009 to support One of the Boys. 74, on August 4, 2009, she performed as opening act for one date of No Doubt's 2009 summer tour. 75, Perry also hosted the 2009 MTV Europe Music Awards in November 2009, becoming the first person to host two consecutive ceremonies of the European Awards. 76, on July 22, 2009, Perry recorded a live album titled MTV Unplugged, which featured acoustic performances of 5 tracks from One of the Boys as well as one new song, Brick by Brick, and a cover of Fountains of Wayne's Hackensack. 77, it was released on November 17, 2009. 78, Perry also appeared on 2 singles with other artists. She was featured on a remix of Colorado-based band 303's song Starstruck in September 2009, 79. And on a duet with Timbaland entitled If We Ever Meet Again, from his album Shock Value 2, 3 months later. 80-81, the Guinness World Records recognized her in its 2010 edition as the best start on the U.S. digital chart by a female artist, for digital single sales of over 2 million copies. 82. After her relationship with Travis McCoy ended in December 2008, 83, Perry met her future husband Russell Brand in the summer of 2009 while filming a cameo appearance for his film Get Him to the Greek. Her scene, in which the two kiss, does not appear in the film. 84, she began dating Brand after meeting him again that September at the 2009 MTV Video Music Awards. 85, the couple became engaged on December 31, 2009, while vacationing in Rajasthan, India. 86. 2010 to 2012, Teenage Dream and First Marriage. After serving as a guest judge on American Idol, 87, Perry released California Girls featuring Snoop Dogg on May 7, 2010. 88, the song was the lead single from her third studio album, Teenage Dream, and reached number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 in June. 89, she also served as a guest judge on British The X Factor later that month 90, before releasing the album's second single, Teenage Dream, in July. 91, Teenage Dream reached number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 in September. 92, released on August 24, 2010, 93, Teenage Dream debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 294, and received mixed reviews from music critics. 95, it has since sold 6 million copies worldwide. 96, Teenage Dream would go on to win the 2011 Juno Award for International Album of the Year. 97, in October, Firework was released as the album's third single. 98, it became the album's third consecutive number one on the Billboard Hot 100 on December 8, 2010. 99. E.T. featuring Kanye West was released as the fourth single from Teenage Dream on February 16, 2011. 100, it topped the Billboard Hot 100 for 5 non-consecutive weeks, making Teenage Dream the 9th album in history to produce 4 number one singles on the chart. 101, Last Friday Night, TGIF, followed as the 5th single in June. 102, and Perry became the first female artist to achieve 5 number 1 Billboard Hot 100 songs from one album when the single topped that chart on August 17, and the second artist after Michael Jackson with his album Bad. 103, for this record, she received an honorary American Music Award in November 2011. 104, and a 2013 Guinness World Record. 105, on September 7, she set a new record by becoming the first artist to spend 69 consecutive weeks in the top 10 of the Hot 100. 106, after The One That Got Away was released as the album's 6th single in October, Teenage Dream became the third album to spawn 6 top 5 songs on the Billboard Hot 100 after Rhythm Nation 1814 by Janet Jackson and Faith by George Michael. 107-108, the song peaked at number 3 in the US, 109, and number 2 in Canada. 65. On January 5, 2012, Perry was named the 6th best-selling digital artist in the United States, with sales of 37.6 million units according to Nielsen SoundScan. 110, that month, she became the first artist to have 4 songs sell over 5 million digital units when E.T. reached that mark along with Firework, California Girls, and Hot and Cold. 111, on February 13, Capitol released the lead single from Teenage Dream, The Complete Confection, Part of Me, which debuted at number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 and became Perry's 7th single overall to top the chart. 112, Teenage Dream, The Complete Confection was released on March 23, 113, and serves as a reissue of Teenage Dream. 114, Wide Awake was released on May 22 as the re-release's 2nd single. 115, peaking at number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100. 109, and number 1 in Canada. 65, and New Zealand. 116. Katy Perry looking forward and smiling. Perry attending the Sydney premiere for her 2012 documentary Katy Perry, Part of Me, which grossed $32.7 million. Perry embarked on her second tour, the California Dreams Tour, in support of Teenage Dream 74, from February 2011 to January 2012. 117, the tour grossed $59.5 million globally. 118, and won her the award for Best Live Act at the 2011 MTV Europe Music Awards. 119, on September 23, 2011, she performed on the opening day of the 2011 Rock in Rio Festival along with Elton John and Rihanna. 120, in September 2010, Perry was scheduled to appear on the 41st season premiere of Sesame Street. After her scene was uploaded to YouTube, viewers criticized Perry's exposed cleavage. 4 days before the scheduled airing, Sesame Workshop announced that the segment would not air on television, but would still be available to watch online. 121, Perry subsequently mocked the controversy on Saturday Night Live, where she was a musical guest and wore an Elmo-themed shirt showing large amounts of cleavage during one skit. 122. In December 2010, Barry played Mos Zizlock's girlfriend in the live-action segment from a Christmas episode of The Simpsons titled The Fight Before Christmas. 123-124, in February 2011, she made a guest appearance on the How I Met Your Mother episode Oh Honey, playing a woman known as Honey. 125, the role won her the People's Choice Award for Favorite TV Guest Star in January 2012. 126, she made her film debut in the 3D family motion picture The Smurfs as Smurfette on July 29, 2011. The film was a financial success worldwide. 127, while critics gave mostly negative reviews. 128, she hosted Saturday Night Live on December 10, 2011, with Robin as the episode's musical guest. Perry's work on the episode received generally positive reviews from critics, who praised her performance in the episode's digital short featuring her and Andy Samberg. 129, in March 2012, she guest starred as a prison security guard named Ricky on the Raising Hope episode Single White Female Role Model. 130, on July 5, 2012, Perry's autobiographical documentary Katy Perry, Part of Me was released to theaters through Paramount Pictures. 131-132, the film received positive reviews. 133, and grossed $32.7 million worldwide at the box office. 134. Perry began to venture into business when she endorsed her first fragrance, Purr, in November 2010. Her second fragrance, Meow, was released in December 2011. Both perfumes were released through Nordstrom department stores. 135-136, Electronic Arts recruited her to promote their new expansion pack for The Sims 3, Showtime. 137, before releasing a separate stuff pack featuring Perry-inspired furniture, outfits, and hairstyles, titled The Sims 3, Katy Perry's Sweet Treats, in June 2012. 138, the following month, she became the spokesperson and ambassador for Popchips and made an investment in the company. 139, Billboard dubbed her as their Woman of the Year for 2012. 140. She married Russell Brand on October 23, 2010, in a traditional Hindu ceremony near the Ranthambore Tiger Sanctuary in Rajasthan, India. 141, Brand announced on December 30, 2011, that they were divorcing after 14 months of marriage. 142, Perry later stated that conflicting career schedules and his desire to have children before she was ready led to the end of their marriage. 143, and that he never spoke to her again after sending a text message that he was divorcing her. 144, while Brand asserted that he divorced her due to her commercial success and reluctance to engage in activism. 145, she was initially distraught over their divorce, and said that she contemplated suicide. 146-147, after the marriage ended in 2012, 148, Barry began a relationship with singer John Mayer that August. 149. 2013-2015, Prism and Super Bowl's Licks halftime show. In November 2012, Barry began work on her fourth album, Prism. 150-146, she told Billboard, "I know exactly the record I want to make next. I know the artwork, the coloring and the tone, and I even know what type of tour I'm doing next. I'll be very pleased if the vision I have in my head becomes a reality." 151, after initially telling Luma Vogue in June 2012 that she planned to have darker elements in Prism following the end of her marriage, the singer revealed to MTV during the 2013 MTV Video Music Awards that she changed the album's direction after periods of self-reflection. Perry commented, "I felt very prismatic," which inspired the album's name. 152-153, Roar was released as the lead single from Prism on August 10, 2013. 154, It was promoted at the MTV Video Music Awards and reached number one on the Billboard Hot 100. 155-156, Unconditionally followed as the second single from Prism on October 16, 2013, 157, and peaked at number 14 in the United States. 158. Katy Perry performing in a pink cloak, during the Prismatic World Tour. Perry performing during the Prismatic World Tour in July 2014. Prism was released on October 18, 2013, and has sold 4 million copies as of August 2015. 159. It received favorable reviews from critics. 150. And debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 200 chart. 160. 4 days later, Perry performed the songs from the album at the iHeartRadio Theater in Los Angeles. 161. Dark Horse with Juicy J was released as the album's third single in December, and became her 9th U.S. number 1 single the following month. 162-163, in 2014, Birthday and This Is How We Do respectively followed as the album's 4th and 5th singles, 164-165, and reached the top 25 on the Hot 100. 63. Prior to ending her relationship with Meyer in February 2014, 166-167, she recorded and co-wrote a duet with him titled Who You Love for his album Paradise Valley. The song was released on August 12, 2013. 168. Perry's third headlining tour, the Prismatic World Tour, began in May 2014. 117. And concluded in October 2015. 159. It sold almost 2 million tickets and grossed $204.3 million worldwide. 169. And won Perry the award for Top Package at the 2014 Billboard Touring Awards. 170. She also performed at the 2015 Rock in Rio Festival on September 27, 2015. 171. On November 23, 2014, the NFL announced that Perry would perform at the Super Bowl's Licks halftime show on February 1, 2015. 172. Lenny Kravitz and Missy Elliott served as special guests for the show. 173. Her performance was critically acclaimed. 174. And the Guinness World Records announced 2 days after the singer's halftime show that it garnered 118.5 million viewers in the United States, becoming the most watched and highest rated show in Super Bowl history. The viewership was higher than the game itself, which was viewed by an audience of 114.4 million. 175. The International Federation of the Phonographic Industry, IFPI, ranked her 5th on the list of top global recording artists of 2013. 176. On June 26, 2014, she was declared the top certified digital artist ever by the Recording Industry Association of America, RIAA, for certified sales of 72 million digital singles in the United States. 177-178, in May 2014. A portrait of Perry by painter Mark Ryden was featured in his exhibition The Gay 90s, and shown at the Kahn Gallery in Los Angeles. Along with several other artists, she also recorded a cover version of the song Daisy Bell, Bicycle Built for Two, on a limited edition concept album titled The Gay 90s Old Time Music, Daisy Bell, to accompany the exhibition. 179. That month, a portrait of Perry by artist Will Cotton was included in the United States National Portrait Gallery. 180. On November 23, 2015, Perry starred in H&M's holiday advertising campaign, for which she wrote and recorded a song titled Every Day is a Holiday. 181-182. On June 17, 2014, Perry announced that she had founded her own record label under Capitol Records, titled Metamorphosis Music. Thurs was the first artist to get signed to her label, and Perry served as an executive producer on his self-titled EP. She also recorded a duet with him on the EP, titled Legends Never Die. 183, the label was later renamed on Sub Records. 184. Outside of her music career, Perry reprised her role as Smurfette in The Smurfs 2, which was released in theaters on July 31, 2013. 185, like its predecessor, The Smurfs 2 was a financial success. 186, but was panned by critics. 187, in March 2014, she made a guest appearance playing herself in the episode Blisteritas Presents at Academy Graduation Congraduritas Red Carpet Viewing Party of The Crawl Show. 188, Killer Queen was released as her third fragrance in August 2013 through Coty Incorporated. 189, in January 2014, she became a guest curator of Madonna's Art for Freedom initiative. 190, in March 2015, she appeared in Brand, A Second Coming, a documentary following her ex-husband Russell Brand's transition from comedy work to activism. 145, and released a concert film titled Katy Perry, The Prismatic World Tour Through Apex, which took place during her tour of the same name. 132, Perry also made a cameo appearance in the music video for Madonna's song Bitch I'm Madonna in June 2015. 191, the following month, she released another fragrance with Coty, entitled Mad Potion. 192, in September 2015, she appeared in the documentary's Katy Perry, Making of the Pepsi Super Bowl Halftime Show, which followed Perry's preparation for her Super Bowl performance. 193, and Jeremy Scott, The People's Designer, which followed the life and career of designer Jeremy Scott. 194, Perry released a mobile app titled Katy Perry Pop in December 2015 through Glue Mobile, where her character helps players become famous musicians. 195, she described it as the most fun, colorful world that helps guide your musical dreams. 196. 2016 to 2018, Witness and American Idol. Perry started writing songs for her new album in June 2016, 197, and recorded an anthem for NBC Sports's coverage of the 2016 Summer Olympics titled Rise, which was released the following month. Perry chose to release it as a standalone track rather than save it for her album because now more than ever, there is a need for our world to unite. NBC also felt its message spoke directly to the spirit of the Olympics and its athletes for its inspirational themes. 198, the song reached number 1 in Australia. 199, and number 11 in the United States. 63. Perry performing during Witness, the tour in October 2017. In August 2016, Perry stated that she aspired to create material that connects and relates and inspires, 200, and told Ryan Seacrest that she was not rushing her fifth album, adding, "I'm just having a lot of fun, but experimenting and trying different producers, and different collaborators, and different styles." 201, on February 10, 2017, Perry released the album's lead single Chain to the Rhythm featuring Skip Marley. 202-203, it reached number 1 in Hungary. 204, and number 4 in the United States. 63, the track was also streamed over 3 million times on Spotify within 24 hours, breaking the music streaming service's record at the time for the highest first-day streaming for a single track by a female artist. 205, the album's second single, Bon Appetit with Migos, was released that April. 206, its third single, Swish Swish, featured Nicki Minaj and followed the next month. 207, they respectively peaked at numbers 59 and 46 in the United States, 63, and made the top 15 in Canada. 65. The album, titled Witness, was released on June 9, 2017, to mixed reviews. 208. And debuted at number 1 in the United States. 209, to accompany the album's release, Perry broadcast herself on YouTube for 4 days with a live stream titled Katy Perry Live, Witness Worldwide, concluding with a live concert on June 12. 210. The live stream generated over 49 million views from 190 different countries. 211. She also embarked on Witness, the tour, which began in September 2017 and ended in August 2018. 212. On June 15, 2017, Calvin Harris released a song titled Feels from his album Funquav Bounces Volume 1, which featured Perry, Big Sean, and Pharrell Williams. 213. The song went on to reach number 1 in the United Kingdom. 214. Perry subsequently recorded a cover of the Dear Evan Hansen song Waving Through a Window for the deluxe edition of the cast recording, which was released on November 2, 2018. 215. The show's creators Benjamin Posack and Justin Paul had requested Perry to cover the song to promote the musical's national tour and bring awareness to mental health. 216. Later that month, Perry released Cozy Little Christmas. 217. She also recorded the song Immortal Flame for the game Final Fantasy Brave Exvius, and had a playable character modeled after her. 218. Outside of recording music, Perry appeared as herself in the film Zoolander 2, which was released in February 2016. 219-220. In February 2017, the singer launched a shoe line titled Katy Perry Collections. 221. Her shoes are available on her website, Katy Perry Collections, and at retailers such as Dillard's and Walmart. 222. The following August, she hosted the 2017 MTV Video Music Awards. 223. Perry was signed for a $25 million salary to serve as a judge on ABC's revival of American Idol, which premiered in March 2018. 224-225. Perry began a relationship with Orlando Bloom in early 2016, and the couple got engaged on February 14, 2019. 226-227. 2019-present, Smile, Motherhood and Play Residency. Perry at iHeartRadio Jingle Ball Tour in Chicago in 2019. At the 61st Annual Grammy Awards, Perry performed Here You Come Again, alongside Dolly Parton and Kacey Musgraves, as part of a tribute to Parton. 228. 4 days later, she released a song called 365, with DJ Zed. 229. In April, Perry was included on a remix of Daddy Yankee's song Con Calma, featuring Snow. 230. She followed this with the singles Never Really Over on May 31, Small Talk on August 9, and Harley's in Hawaii on October 16. 231-232-233. In June 2019, Perry appeared in the music video of Taylor Swift's You Need to Calm Down. 234. In July, a jury in California passed a verdict following a week-long trial that Perry's song Dark Horse had copied Flame's 2008 song Joyful Noise after he filed a copyright lawsuit alleging that it used his track's beat without permission. 235, which was later overturned. 236, after the initial verdict, the jury ordered her to pay him $550,000. 237, the next month, Josh Kloss, Perry's co-star in the Teenage Dream music video, accused her of sexual misconduct. 238, in an Instagram post, Kloss alleged that, during a party at a skating rink, Perry pulled on his sweatpants and underwear, exposing his penis to her male friends. He also accused her management prevented him from speaking about his time with the singer. However, Johnny Wojcik, the creative director of said party, defended Perry, saying that she would never do something like that and accused him of having an ongoing obsession with her. 239, after initially refraining from responding to this, believing it would have detracted from the Me Too movement, Perry has also denied Kloss's claims. 240. Following the release of her single Never Worn White in March 2020, Berry revealed in the accompanying music video that she was expecting her first child with Bloom. 241, Daisies, the lead single from her sixth album, was released on May 15, 2020. Its second single Smile followed 2 months later. 242-243, the album, also titled Smile, was released on August 28, 2020. 244-245, 2 days before its distribution, she gave birth to a daughter named Daisy Dove Bloom. 246, the album received mixed reviews. 247, and debuted at number 5 in the United States. 248, Berry further promoted the album with 4 compilation EPs, Camp Katie, 249, Empowered, 250, Scorpio SZN, 251, and Cosmic Energy. 252, these EPs were followed by the single Not the End of the World in December 2020. Which had a music video in which Zooey Deschanel impersonates Berry. 253-254-255, additionally she collaborated with various artists to create 2 remixes of Smile album tracks. Tiësto remix of Resilient featuring Aitana was released in November 2020, while Bruno Martini remix of Cry About It later featuring Luis Sonzo was released in April 2021. 256, in January 20, 2021, Berry performed Firework at the Celebrating America concert during the inauguration of Joe Biden. 257, 4 months later, she released a new single, Electric, a collaboration with Pokemon for their 25th anniversary. 258. Berry will begin to host a residency named Play at Resorts World Las Vegas on December 29, 2021. 259, the show's inception happened during the COVID-19 lockdown with Berry being inspired by 1990s movies such as Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, Pee-wee's Playhouse, and Pee-wee's Big Adventure. She described it as larger than life and the cookiest, most camp show I've ever put together. 260. In September 2021, Variety paid tribute to and honored Berry on their Power of Women issue, where she discussed her career, motherhood, and philanthropy. 261. As a nominee, she attended the Variety 2021 Power of Women dinner. 262. On her 37th birthday the following month, Berry guest hosted the Ellen DeGeneres Show. 263. And starred in a holiday advertisement for Gap Incorporated, which featured her singing All You Need Is Love by the Beatles. A full version of her cover was released on streaming platforms the same day. 264, 2 months later, Berry followed this with When I'm Gone, a collaboration with Alesso. 260. Artistry. Influences. Alanis Morissette playing guitar. Freddie Mercury performing. Alanis Morissette, left, and Freddie Mercury, right, both heavily influenced Berry and her music. Berry cites her sister Angela as the woman who has had the most influence on her. 261, during the early stages of her career, Berry's musical style gravitated towards gospel and she aspired to be as successful as Amy Grant. 265, at age 15, she heard Killer Queen by Queen, which inspired her to pursue a music career. 266, she cites the band's frontman, Freddie Mercury, as her biggest influence and expressed how the combination of his sarcastic approach to writing lyrics and his I don't give a fuck attitude inspired her music. 267, she paid homage to the band by naming her third fragrance Killer Queen. 189, Berry described the Beach Boys and their album Pet Sounds as having a considerable influence on her music. Pet Sounds is one of my favorite records and it influenced pretty much all of my songwriting. All of the melody choices that I make are because of Pet Sounds. 268, the singer also holds the Beatles album The Beatles in high esteem, and described these 2 albums as the only things I listened to for probably 2 years straight. 269. She cites Alanis Morissette and her 1995 album Jagged Little Pill as a significant musical inspiration, stating in 2012, "Jagged Little Pill was the most perfect female record ever made. There's a song for anyone on that record, I relate to all those songs. They're still so timeless." Additionally, Perry borrows influence from Flaming Red by Patti Griffin and 10 Cent Wings by Jonita Brooke. 270. Perry's autobiographical documentary Katy Perry, Part of Me was largely influenced by Madonna, Truth or Dare. She admires Madonna's ability to reinvent herself, saying, "I want to evolve like Madonna." 271. Perry names Bjork as an influence, particularly admiring her willingness to always be taking chances. 270. Other artists who Perry has cited as influences include Stevie Nicks, 272, ABBA, The Cardigans, 273, Incubus, 274, Cyndi Lauper, 275, Ace of Base, 303, 276, Spinniston, C&C Music Factory, Black Box, Crystal Waters, Mariah Carey, 277, Heart, Joni Mitchell, Paul Simon, Imogen Heap, Rufus Wainwright, 278, Pink, 279, and Gwen Stefani. 270. Firework was inspired by a passage in the book On the Road by Jack Kerouac, in which the author compares people who are full of life to fireworks that shoot across the sky and make people watch in awe. 280. Her second concert tour, the California Dreams Tour, was reminiscent of Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and The Wonderful Wizard of Oz. 281. She also credits the 1996 film The Craft for inspiring her song Dark Horse. 282. And Eckhart Tolle's book The Power of Now for influencing Prism. 146. Musical style and themes. When I am in between records, sometimes I doubt myself. I'll be like, did I just get lucky, or did I mass manipulate the world into thinking that 7 songs were worth a number one position? And then I go back into the studio and I start writing, and the true essential oil of who I am comes bubbling back up and reminds me that it's always been inside of me, that nobody can take this away no matter what comment anyone makes. Perry on her confidence as a songwriter. 283. While Perry's music incorporates pop, rock, and disco, Katy Hudson contains gospel. Her subsequent releases, One of the Boys and Teenage Dream, involve themes of sex and love. One of the Boys is a pop rock record, while Teenage Dream features disco influences. 284-285, Perry's fourth album, Prism, is significantly influenced by dance and pop music. Lyrically, the album addresses relationships, self-reflection, and everyday life. 286. Her fifth studio effort, Witness, is an electropop album that she described as a 360-degree liberation record, with themes including political liberation, sexual liberation, and liberation from negativity. 287-288. Many of her songs, particularly on Teenage Dream, reflect on love between teenagers. W Magazine described the album's sexual innuendos as irresistible hook-laden melodies. 33. Self-empowerment is a common theme in Perry's music. 289. Perry has described herself as a singer-songwriter masquerading as a pop star. 290. And maintains that honest songwriting is very important to her. She told Marie Claire, "I feel like my secret magic trick that separates me from a lot of my peers is the bravery to be vulnerable and truthful and honest. I think you become more relatable when you're vulnerable." 17. Actress and comedian Kristen Wiig commented that as easy, breezy, and infectious as Perry's songs can be, beneath the surface lurks a sea of mixed emotions, jumbled motives, and contradictory impulses complicated enough to fill a Carole King record. 269. According to Greg Cott of the Chicago Tribune, being taken seriously may be Perry's greatest challenge yet. 291. In 2013, The New York Times labeled her the most potent pop star of the day. Her hits are relatable with just a hint of experimentation. 292. Randall Roberts of the Los Angeles Times criticized her use of idioms and metaphors in her lyrics and for frequent cliches. 293. Throughout her career, Perry has also co-written songs recorded by other artists, including Leslie Roy, 294, Kelly Clarkson, 295, Jesse James Decker, 296, Selena Gomez and The Scene, 297-298, Britney Spears, 299, Iggy Azalea, Rita Ora, 300, Nicki Minaj, and Ariana Grande. 301. Voice. Perry possesses a contralto vocal range. 302-303, her singing has received both praise and criticism. Betty Clark of The Guardian commented that her powerful voice is hard-edged, 304, while Rob Sheffield from Rolling Stone described Perry's vocals on Teenage Dream as processed staccato blips. 285. Darren Harvey of Musicom compared Perry's vocals on One of the Boys to Alanis Morissette's, both possessing a perky voice shifting octaves mid-syllable. 305. Alex Miller from NME felt that Perry's problem is often her voice on One of the Boys, stating that somewhere along the line someone convinced her she was like, well, a ballsy rock chick. 306. Conversely, Bernadette McNulty from the Daily Telegraph praised her rock chick voice in a review of a concert promoting Prism. 307. Public image. Perry performing in a dress decorated with peppermint swirls. Perry in her signature spinning peppermint swirl dress at the California Dreams Tour, 2011. On social media, Perry surpassed Justin Bieber as the most followed person on Twitter in November 2013. 308. She won the 2015 Guinness World Record for most Twitter followers, 309, and became the first person to gain 100 million followers on the site in June 2017. 310. Keith Caulfield of Billboard stated that Perry is the rare celebrity who seems to have enormous popularity but genuine ground-level interaction with her adoring Katy Katz. 311. With a combined total of over 292 million followers across Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, she is the sixth most followed musician across social media. 312. In June 2017, Time magazine listed Perry among its 25 most influential people on the Internet of the year, writing that her live stream for Witness was blazing a trail for being the closest any major entertainer has come to giving fans the kind of real intimacy that social media purports to provide. 313. In 2011, Forbes ranked Perry third on their top-earning women in music list with earnings of $44 million. 314. And fifth on their 2012 list with $45 million. 315. She subsequently ranked seventh on the 2013 Forbes list for top-earning women in music with $39 million earned, 316, and fifth on their 2014 list with $40 million. 317. With earnings of $135 million. Forbes also ranked Perry number one on their 2015 top-earning women in music list as well as the world's highest-paid musicians and declared her the highest-earning female celebrity in 2015, placing her at number three on the Forbes Celebrity 100 list. 318. In 2016, the magazine estimated her net worth was $125 million. 319. And ranked her number six on their list of highest paid women in music with earnings of $41 million. 320. The following year, she was ranked number nine on the list with $33 million. 321. In 2018, she topped its highest paid women in music listing and ranked at number four on the highest paid female celebrities list with earnings of $83 million. 322-323, Barry subsequently was placed at number 4 on the 2019 highest paid women in music listings with $57.5 million. 324, later that year, with earnings of $530 million throughout the 2010s, the magazine also ranked her as the 9th highest earning musician of the decade. 325. Fashion. Perry has been described as a sex symbol. GQ labeled her a full-on male fantasy. 11, while Elle wrote her body looked as though sketched by a teenage boy. 24, Vice called her a serious pop star slash woman slash sex symbol. 326, she was placed at number 1 on the Maxim Hot 100 in 2010 as the most beautiful woman in the world, with editor Joe Levy describing her as a triple, no quadruple, kind of hot. 327, Men's Health readers voted her the sexiest woman of 2013. 328, in November 2010, Perry told Harper's Bazaar that she was proud of and satisfied with her figure. 329. Perry's fashion often incorporates humor, bright colors, and food-related themes. 330, such as her characteristic spinning peppermint swirl dress. 331, Vogue described her as never exactly one to shy away from the outrageous or the extreme in any realm. 332, while Glamour named her the Queen of Quirk. 333, in February 2009, Perry told 17 that her fashion style was a bit of a concoction of different things and stated she enjoyed humor in her clothing. 334, she has also described herself as having multi-personality disorder for fashion. 329, Perry lists Gwen Stefani, Shirley Manson, Chloe Sevigny, Daphne Guinness, Natalie Portman, and the fictional character Lolita as her style icons. 33-335. Legacy and influence. Media outlets such as Billboard and Glamour have referred to Perry as the new or reigning queen of pop. 336-337, Andrew Unterberger of Billboard described Teenage Dream one of the defining LPs from a new golden age in megapop. 338, while Christopher Rosa of Glamour named her as an influence to the pop sound and style of the 2010s, adding that her singles are some of the most recognizable, iconic, and impactful hits in pop history. Additionally, Perry was included in Glamour's 104 Women Who Defined the 2010s in pop culture list, saying, Perry did more than just break chart records. She was one of the driving forces behind the sound of pop radio in the 2010s, glossy, booming, sugary sweet, and undeniably catchy. 339-340. Variety included Perry in their Variety 500 list of the most influential business leaders, calling her a global phenomenon and a dedicated artist and tireless self-promoter who has leveraged chart-topping hits, sold-out stadium shows, and staggering endorsement deals to become one of the richest and most influential pop stars alive. 341, she has been called a gay icon. 260. Perry's music has been described by Out as having a lasting legacy, with singer Fletcher sampling I Kissed a Girl and singer Olivia Rodrigo referencing Teenage Dream on Brutal. 260, additionally, other artists such as Halsey and Ariana Grande have praised Teenage Dream, with Halsey calling this the perfect pop album and Grande saying The One That Got Away is one of the biggest and most perfectly written pop songs ever from one of the best pop albums of all time. 342-343, Perry and her work have influenced artists such as Lil Nas X, Halsey, Lorde, and Doja Cat. 344-345-343-346. Other ventures. Philanthropy. Perry posing for photographers at a UNICEF gala. Perry became a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador in December 2013. Perry has supported various charitable organizations and causes throughout her career. She has contributed to organizations aimed at improving the lives and welfare of children in particular. In April 2013, she joined UNICEF to assist children in Madagascar with education and nutrition. 347, on December 3, 2013, she was officially named a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador, with a special focus on engaging young people in the agency's work to improve the lives of the world's most vulnerable children and adolescents. 348, she arranged for a portion of the money generated from tickets to her Prismatic World Tour to go to UNICEF. 349, in September 2010, she helped build and design the Boys Hope, Girls Hope Foundation shelter for youth in Baltimore, Maryland, along with Raven Simone, Shaquille O'Neal, and the cast of Extreme Makeover, Home Edition. 350, in 2010, Barry and Nicki Minaj performed a cover of Girls Just Wanna Have Fun for service members during the 2010 VH1 Divas Salute the Troops concert. 351. She has also supported children's education and well-being. All profits from sales of the album The Gay 90s Old Time Music, Daisy Bell, which includes her rendition of Daisy Bell, Bicycle Built for Two, were donated to the charity Little Kids Rock, which supports musical education in underprivileged elementary schools. 179. In June 2014, she teamed up with Staples Incorporated for a project entitled Make Roar Happen, which donated $1 million to Donors Choose, an organization that supports teachers and funds classroom resources in public schools. 352. In May 2016, she worked with UNICEF to improve child care quality in Vietnam, hoping to break the cycle of poverty and drastically improve children's health, education and well-being. 353, the following month, UNICEF announced that Perry would receive the Audrey Hepburn Humanitarian Award for her work as a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador in support of the world's most vulnerable children at their annual Snowflake Ball in November. 354, all Spotify streams of her 2021 cover of All You Need Is Love will generate $1 in donations for the charity Baby to Baby. 264. Perry and Nicki Minaj, right, performing for service members during the 2010 VH1 Divas Salute the Troops concert. Perry has supported organizations aimed at aiding people suffering with diseases including cancer and HIV/AIDS. During the 2008 Warped Tour, she had a cast made of her breasts to raise money for the Keep a Breast Foundation. 355. She hosted and performed at the We Can Survive concert along with Bonnie McKee, Kacey Musgraves, Sarah Bareilles, Ellie Goulding, and Duo Tegan and Sarah at the Hollywood Bowl in Los Angeles, California, on October 23, 2013. The concert's profits were donated to Young Survival Coalition, an organization aiding breast cancer in young women. 356. In June 2009, she designed an item of clothing for H&M's Fashion Against AIDS campaign, which raises money for HIV/AIDS awareness. P.